the concept of the multiverse, the concept of alternative universes.
That there is one universe and within it are subverses or multiverses.
Well, you heard that right, the multiverse. One of the most baffling questions in astrophysics is, are we really a part of an infinite universes? The Big Bang happened 13.8 billion years ago, and the speed of light is constant, as far as we know it. Even though the universe might be infinite, the observable universe is finite. So perhaps our universe may be just one minuscule region in a larger multiverse. So let's take a look at this amazing theory of multiverse. And do we really live in one? Before we go any deeper, let's talk about this concept of uniqueness. Uniqueness is one of those ideas that is unquestionable. There are very low chances of something being identical to it, just like your fingerprints. But in a very recent picture of the cosmos, which says nothing is unique, the very notion of uniqueness is being challenged. It says that there might be duplicates of everything. Not only of objects, but of me, you, everyone, and everything else. And if it's right, why haven't we seen them? And where are they? There was a time when the idea of a multiverse seemed impossible. But in recent years, scientists have discovered some compelling evidence of other universes. Some being born at all time. They might look identical to us, having the same star, and even the same planets. They might also have our duplicates, very identical to us. Except for the slightest details. In another universe, it might be possible that we would be dying or being born, we could be getting married, or perhaps we could even be the president of the United States. Of course, not us per se, but our identical selves. But how is this possible? Doesn't this idea seem absurd? Let's take a look at why this idea is compelling, not only to us, but also to the scientists. Let's talk about where the idea of the multiverse came from. We all know about the Big Bang theory. It tells us about the massive explosion that led to the formation of our universe. But the Big Bang misses one thing. It doesn't tell us anything about the bang. What caused the bang and how it banged? As a matter of fact, our universe has been expanding since the Big Bang, which means that everything is moving away from each other because the space between them is expanding. In 1979, Alan Guth was studying the particles in the early universe. He observed that under the violent and harsh environments, gravity can be repulsive. This repulsive gravity would drive apart everything around and repel it, causing a massive expansion. This force was so powerful that it could take a molecule and blow it up to the size of a galaxy in less than a billionth of a billionth of a blink of an eye. This idea gave birth to the theory of inflation. Then, the theory of multiverse gained unexpected support from two major areas of modern science, and these may be the key to understanding the many important phenomena in our universe and beyond. In the 20th century, astronomers believed that the universe might be shrinking or might be slowing down. The analogy is like when you throw a ball up in the air, it comes back to you after some time. Astronomers believed that the universe was expanding and thought it would slow down, because of the gravitational pull of the stars and galaxies. But when detailed observations were made, especially by Edwin Hubble, astronomers observed that the universe was not slowing down. Instead, it was accelerating outwards. Everything was moving away from each other at an increasing speed. Scientists believed that there had to be an invisible force behind this. Astronomers call it dark energy. Dark energy is one of the most important discoveries in astrophysics. However, there was another aspect of this strange force, its strength. Scientists believe that at quantum level, the amount of energy that will be generated is gigantic. When astronomers measured the amount of dark energy present in our universe, it was in the order of negative 120. Imagine a number so small it has 119 zeros after the decimal point. That seems like an infinitely small number. But then, astronomers found out that if this tiny amount of dark energy would have been just slightly larger or lower, life as we know it wouldn't exist. So how can this amount of dark energy be so perfect for our universe? The multiverse gives us an answer. The amount of dark energy differs in every universe. In some, it might be so less that the matter would collapse in on itself, and hence nothing could exist. In others, dark energy is so large that matter could never get a chance to form and nothing would even exist. And this was a baffling realization for scientists. But there was another piece of this puzzle missing. How can we be so sure about this diversification of universes so that every value for dark energy, including the value in our universe, can be found somewhere else? The answer lies within the string theory. To put it simply, string theory proposes that at subatomic levels, small particles, or here we call them quarks, are made up of small vibrating loops of energy, or strings. They can create different particles based on how they vibrate. This theory is believed to lay the foundation for one fundamental equation for our universe. String theory also proposes extra dimensions of space. We are familiar with the three dimensions of space: length, depth, and height. Let's now suppose we look at a wire hanging at a distance from us. If we observe it, it looks like a line, one-dimensional. But what about an end that's on the wire? It would see an extra dimension. And if we could shrink down billions of times than the ends, we will find extra dimensions curled up into loops everywhere in space. The shape of those dimensions determine how the strings will vibrate. And this vibration of space defines the different properties of the particles. When scientists tried to find out these different shapes, they were blown away by the million possibilities of shapes, each as unique as the other one. And this was heartbreaking for them. What good is a theory that has billions of solutions? Finding anything would almost be impossible. But some string theorists thought to look at the problem differently, a way that would lead to a multiverse. This diversification of possible shapes says that string theory fits perfectly for cosmology and multiverse. All these different shapes might correspond to a different unique universe. String theory was describing a multiverse, a very distinct multiverse. At the end of the day, scientists can see three different theories pointing to a single theory, the theory of multiverse. Different lines of research were focusing on one idea, and the theory of multiverse seemed convincing. All the various alternate universes out there might have different amount of dark energy naturally, and the unique shapes of these extra dimensions. In the future, we might see other advances in this research, but as of now, we can't observe beyond the observable universe, as the space between these galaxies and the space itself is expanding. So what do you think about these different theories pointing towards the multiverse? Could it really be possible that we are currently living in one right now? Let us know your thoughts and questions in the comment sections below, and don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel, and press the bell notification button to always get notified for more curiosity videos like this. Thanks.